My name is Eric Santoscoy-McKillip. I was born and raised in El Paso, Texas, and I currently live and work in Brooklyn, New York. My work is an examination of place and identity through the use of color, form, and shape, and texture. Within my current body of work, I've been focusing on the use of stucco and the way in which it has been used for millennia throughout the entire world, both as a surface and a protectant for the elements. Stucco is applied on the outer surfaces of buildings that are made out of brick or adobe as a protectant layer. And so what I've been thinking is how it is like a skin that protects the internal body. Stucco has an embedded meaning within it, and like a pluralities of meanings. It is the sound of labor by the mixing and the application of it. It has memory as like that is invoked for me from when my grandfather would be mixing it to fix a house or build a wall. So within these pieces, I've been thinking about the way in which the Chicanx artists of the 1960s and 70s were looking backwards to relearn a history that was lost due to assimilation. And so within my current line of work, I'm looking back on my own family's heritage in Mexico and in the border, and the way in which architecture then influences things that might be taken for granted in terms of architecture that occurs in that specific place. The ideas of border phenomenon and geopolitical borders are like the sources of abstraction within these pieces. And so for each element, like let's say color, I'm thinking about the way in which two colors can sit next to each other and harmonize, but also speak of division and how those things are able to live with one another. Texture, again, with stucco, allows for there to be like homogeneity between two different structures next to one another, but also allow for there to be tension. And shape, in all of these pieces that I've been doing recently, going back to the ideas of architecture, growing up on the border, there's different kind of phenomena that exist. El Paso itself doesn't necessarily have a unified architectural style and has basically followed the rest of the surrounding area in terms of its architectural styles. But from growing up there, I noticed how there were certain specific like steps that you see used in architecture, whether it's both like public or private, and where I was always interested in where that was coming from. And so like over the years of traveling back and forth between Mexico and the United States, going and starting to like actually understand the history of those places and the migration north, I have been thinking about the way in which there's also the movement of knowledge and how those specific things architecturally might be something of structure, but also for symbol.